Hey, what's up, guys? Spencer Rhodes here. So, for those of you that don't know, I've been making theory videos about how I believe that Season 5 of Fear the Walking Dead will be Strand's final season. And keep in mind, Strand is one of my favorite characters. He's literally in my top four favorite characters of the entire show. And I love him. I love the actor. I don't want him to die, but I just started to really think that he was going to die this season, probably even in the first half of the season, because there tends to be one or two big deaths in the first half of every season of both Fear and The Walking Dead. And I thought that maybe Strand was going to be the big death of the first half of the season, or maybe the second half of the season, but it just seemed like they were really, really foreshadowing it and making a big deal about Strand being heroic and him trying to make up for his past and him trying to be a better person. It just seemed like they're setting up him sacrificing himself heroically and being like the big death of season five, which I kind of have some issues with that because he's one of the three season one characters left along with Daniel and Alicia. And right now, I guess he's basically one of the two because I guess Daniel left again. I don't know if Daniel's going to be coming back for the rest of season five or not, but yeah, either way, even if we get Daniel in episode six or whatever, Strand is still one of the last three season one characters left, and I don't really want them to kill him off, but it just seemed like they were really, really setting it up. So I made a few videos about it. But after last episode, after this past Sunday's episode, I don't know anymore. Maybe that story arc's complete for Strand, that whole thing with him being guilty about his past, and maybe this is the part of the season where Strand gets something new to do, a new story arc, you know, something new for the character, which I think is really cool because I think the character has potential to make it to season six. But hopefully they've resolved this whole thing about him being guilty about his past because, you know, although Daniel sort of blamed him for keeping him from ever seeing Ophelia, Strand ended up saving Daniel's life at this point because Daniel was almost getting killed by a big group of walkers, but Strand turned on the helicopter and killed the walkers and saved Daniel, but broke the helicopter so they can't rescue Morgan, Alicia, and everyone else. So that helicopter was kind of fucked up, but it also saved Daniel. So basically, Daniel forgave Strand. Well, you know, kind of forgave Strand because Daniel promised to kill Strand. He promised to shoot him in the face, and then Daniel said, "I'm not going to do that." So it's sort of just slightly making amends with each other, you know, sort of turning the page, I guess, and moving on. But yeah, it seems like Daniel might be leaving for the season, and that plot point for Strand is resolved. So, I don't know if Strand has to die or not this season. I don't know if he has to die heroically to prove that he's not the same person anymore, because he's already proven that he's not the same person anymore. You know, the fact that he broke the helicopter to save Daniel, you know, I think that was a good redemption for Strand. So maybe that part of his character is complete for the season, and, you know, therefore he doesn't have to be the big death of the season. Maybe that can be June or Luciana or whoever the fuck, but maybe Strand can make it to season six. And, you know, maybe, like I said, because if this story arc is done, then Strand doesn't have to redeem himself anymore. He can just be a part of the story in a different way. But it's not 100% proof that Strand is going to be in season six. There's still 12 episodes left. There's still going to be a big death at some point. Like, if we get through all of season five without a big death, I'll be pretty surprised. I won't be, like, mad, because I kind of get it. You know, if they all make it to season six, I kind of get that. I don't know. I like most of the characters right now, but I really doubt it. I really doubt we'll go an entire season without a big death. So I think someone will die. Like I said, maybe June, Luciana, Sarah, Wendell. But someone will probably die. If it's Morgan, you know, I will, like, take out my fucking chainsaw and slaughter some bitches. Okay, I'm kidding, I'm joking. I'd be really mad, though. I'd be really disappointed. That'd pretty much ruin the show for me. Maybe even the franchise. Like, Morgan's my guy. But, yeah. They could make Strand the big death. They could make him the big death of the season. But, like I said, they can make it someone else. I feel like it doesn't have to be Strand anymore. They can just sort of move on from that part of his story arc and have him do different things, and someone else can be the big death. So at this point, there is a chance that Strand is going to survive to season six. I'd say there's probably a 40% chance he'll survive to season six, and a 60% chance that he'll die in season five. I still think there's a pretty good chance that Strand could die, maybe a sacrificial type death, maybe a different death, but I think it's possible. It's possible, but I hope he doesn't. I don't know. There's just 12 more episodes left, so I'm not sure. But yeah, I think there's still a fair chance that Strand could die. It's a whole lot better than what I thought. I was like 99% sure Strand was gonna die this season. Now I'm not that sure anymore. Anyway, that's all I have for this video. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Don't be shy. Hit that like and subscribe. I'm not going anywhere. I make 1 to 2 Walking Dead videos per day, so please hit that subscribe button. Right now we are at 555 subscribers. My goal is to try to get to 600 in the next few months. So we are at just 45 subscribers away from 600. That's pretty good. Just 45 subscribers, 45 people away from 600. Like, that's not that bad. We're actually pretty close to 600 when you think about it. So I'd say we're probably going to get to 600 before 2020, and that's pretty awesome. Like, 600 people, just knowing that 600 people have subscribed to your channel, that, you know, and it's not people that you paid for or anything. Those are all people that just decided to subscribe to my daily content. That's just really awesome, and I'm really happy that we are getting closer and closer to that milestone. So just remember, every subscriber counts. Every bit of support matters, and it is very, very appreciated. Can't wait to get to that goal. But yeah, anyway, with all that said, I am Spencer Rhodes, and I will see you guys later. Bye.